guys, YDCB here with some more Summoners War action. Today we'll be doing some special tactics, alright? And they'll be involving mostly Groggle and even Trevor. And these are situational things that you don't see every day, but are really fun to play with. How about the second one with Gianna? Now I devised a special strategy for Gianna, because I see so much of her, you know, in RTA. But it doesn't really work in RTA. But it does work in an arena where we see a lot of Gianna. So I decided to, you know, invest some runes into our little friend over here. This guy. So this is an RTA, so it's AI controlled. Now if you look at this, okay, Gianna is always gonna bomb, always gonna attack my Golem. The bombs are only maximum gonna do 20% of his HP. Frigate is only ever going to armor break my Golem. Alright, he's on Despair Revenge. He's got really high resistance. I made it so. I made it so he has high resistance so we can resist some bombs if we're lucky. Right? So, like I said, Frigate is only ever gonna armor break Groggle. So every, and if I bring double fire, Ciara is only ever going to bomb Groggle. So I have freedom over these last two slots to make something happen here. Okay, so I can either A, bring a cleanser, but really is a cleanser useful? Is a cleanser useful because what's happening is that the bomb's gonna be detonated. So we really have nothing to cleanse. So I don't really need, I was thinking you bring Lisa, but you know, definitely Fire Monkey. Why? Because Frigate will stun, right? And I don't want to be stunned up. I want to have everything that I have in my, you know, available to be able to kill this Ciara first and foremost, ASAP. Now, you know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking, instead of a healer, which I feel is safer, can we take it a step further? Alright? I'm gonna bring P-Sama into this. Okay? So, what's gonna happen? The fight starts, I believe Frigate should move first, giving them the attack bar or whatever. I don't really care what he does. Alright? And then Gianna is going to bomb. This should be the turn order. Gianna should move before Ciara. Gianna is going to bomb Groggle. Alright, or cleanse, or strip, or whatever, I don't really care. Even if she bombs Groggle, the bomb doesn't go off yet. Alright, but Ciara is not bombing Groggle. Ciara is bombing P-Sama. It's gonna kill P-Sama if the bomb lands. Okay, and then P-Sama comes back, you know, he dies, he comes back, he does good damage. Now, if he does not glance Ciara, Monkey will be able to finish off Ciara in one shot. And then, we're suddenly 3v2 against them. It should be in the bag. Okay, here we go. This is it. I'm excited for this one. Yes, you bomb. Oh, really? I don't resist it. Okay, fine. I don't resist it. Okay, here we go. Here it is. Here. Just detonate. He comes back. We do damage. Oh, wow. Did you see that? Did you see that, guys? The Groggle revenge and stun. Oh my god. Look at Groggle. He's standing strong. Now we do this. Overwhelm. Oh, yeah. Now, I have like so many choices here. I'm gonna go for Ciara because the rest don't matter. They can't kill Groggle. I'm gonna go for Ciara. Oh, wow, this Ciara's tanky though. Oh my god. Iron Jesus. Oh, look at Groggle. Look at him. Iron defense. Oh my god. Alright, you wanna kill P-Sama? Fuck you. You don't go for P-Sama. I'm intentionally leaving Gianna alive. Oh, actually, I'm not. Oh my god. Project successful. Feels so good. I intentionally made Groggle just for Gianna. I mean, it was working out fine. I mean, granted, we had some props, granted. Let's take a look at the one below. We've got Galleon, Tiana, and Zyros. Groggle is gonna excel here because it's like huge nukes that they depend on, but the huge nuke is only going to do 20% of Groggle's HP. And he still have 80% of his HP to play around with and wreak havoc on this team. Alright, for this team, not only are we going Groggle as a defense naturally, we're also going Tracker. Because he cannot be armor broken and he shits on Zyros pretty much. Now for the last slot, it's really flexible. You can actually go anything that you want. It can be a Jotun. For this case, we're just gonna go Rina because we're a pussy. Just in case, you know, shit happens, we can actually get some heals out. So I'm gonna go HP for Groggle, and this should work out really fine. Okay, Winds of Change, I don't even care. Get and go, time to loot. Alright, you get it on Groggo. Basically, he gets everyone, just that you can't get Tracker. See, Groggo is still alive. Plus, we get the start on Zyros. I'm not in a hurry to kill Zyros, though. I'm more interested to kill, what's his face, Galleon, rather than Zyros, right? I'm gonna work on Galleon here. Who should I stun here? Let's stun Zyros, cause fuck him. Okay, let's stun Zyros, cause fuck him. And then, good, you removed the armor break, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Continue stunning Zyros. Just cause we can. Okay, just cause we can. Again, stun Zyros. This is so stupid. You know what? Let's stun this Galleon. You see, Zyros gets a hit off. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Fuck off. It doesn't matter. The whole thing is about making Arena super slow is that the armor break sticks to. Look at that. One heal. We're back up to full. Huh? The whole point of using Arena here is that she's super slow. The armor break's gonna stick on her. So this way, Groggo will be even safer. Yeah, it's gonna be even safer. So he's really effective against those type of comms that require, that depend on a huge single target nuke. Right? Because that huge single target nuke is only gonna deal like 20% of his HP. No problemo. Yeah? You see what I'm saying? This guy, it's not something that you want a 6-star right off the bat. But he's really good in situational, in certain situations, alright? And that's what Endgame Guild Wars is all about, having more tools for certain specific situations. And for this specific situation, I think it's fair to say that we shat on this team with like Nat Trees. Right? Full Nat Trees. And it will work 100% of the time. Sekhmet Chandra Ritesh. Trevor shines in situations like this. Because there is AoE cleave that won't directly deal huge damage to him. Right? There's AoE cleave that won't directly deal huge damage to him. Which makes it that his passive will tick in. But not to a point where it's fatal. So we're gonna go ahead and pick Trevor here. And I'm thinking, I want something that Ritesh is just gonna, keep attacking. So, I'm gonna go with Tractor here. I'm gonna go with Tractor here. Ritesh is gonna keep pounding on him, but Tractor don't really give a shit. And I'm gonna use Tractor to keep this Chandra locked down. Okay? Now for the last slot, it's really flexible, but for this situation, I'm actually gonna go with a cleanser, and I'm gonna pick Annabelle because I feel that this fight could go a little long, and since my Trevor is not a vampire, neither is my Tractor, okay? So they might need certain form of sustain, and Annabelle's sustain is best in this situation because the heal block that Sekhmet puts down on us, she will cleanse that and then heal. So I think she's perfect healer for this situation. Alright, here we go. There we go, she resets Trevor. But Trevor don't really give a shit. Right, Trevor, the first hit that Trevor goes out, that gives out, it's always gonna be the attack buff anyway. Personally, that's what I do. Right, we're gonna try stun this guy. Oh wow, he violence out of stun? Okay, so he gets armor break on Annabelle, that is not too cool. What I'm gonna do here, alright, I'm gonna attempt to take out, wait. Should I do armor break? I mean, if I do armor break now, nah, I'm gonna heal. Because I don't like the armor break, yeah? We take this away. We stun this Chandra up. Okay, hopefully he doesn't violent or stun as well. Oh my god, this fucking Sekhmet though. She's getting really irritating for me. Because she's making Trevor weak. I don't like that. I'm gonna armor break now. Hopefully, we get, get armor break on either. Can we get it on Ritesh? Oh, we can't. That's too bad. Maybe we can sleep this bitch before she just curses the beautiful. Oh, okay. Can we sleep this guy as well? Oh, we didn't get it, but it's okay. I'm gonna keep Chandra locked down. I told you, that's what we're gonna do. Okay, and then even with the tag break, I think we can kill the Sekhmet. See, you see? We're gonna continue keeping Chandra locked down. If I can get an armor break on Ritesh, it's game over. Oh, I can't. Okay, okay. Now we need to actually focus on Ritesh before he kills Annabelle. Oh! I need to stun Ritesh! Thank you. Work on Ritesh so that he does meditate next. And then we do cleanse. And suddenly we're okay again. Can I sleep this Chandra? I can't. But it's okay, I can stun him. I feel so dirty! The stuns! You see, it's just happening! You put Tracker in despair! It's like he gets this. He for sure gets the stun. Ciara, Tiana, and Kumar. In this situation, there is no armor breaker. Yes, Tiana armor breaks, but who does Tiana armor break? Anything that is not fire. Am I right? So, this is where Groggo is going to shine again. So we pick Groggo. Ciara is only ever going to bomb Groggo if I bring double fire. Alright, so I am going to bring double fire. I'm gonna go with Fire Monkey over here. And because there is cleave damage, okay, from Ciara's detonation, from Kumar's trick of a fire, I'm gonna go with Trevor. Yeah, so we get to see Groggo and Trevor in one fight, and I think it's gonna work out fine. Alright, here we go. Oh, Tiana doesn't do it actually. She doesn't do the. So you see there's already some damage. There's already some damage onto Groggo. Already some damage. I'm actually gonna leave Groggo alive. I'm gonna work on this Kumar over here. Yeah, I'm gonna work on this Kumar. And he does Trick of Fire, which gives Trevor even more attack. But I like the attack buff. The problem here is, I see Tiana is going to move next. Tiana's gonna move. So even if I do the self-attack buff, alright, unless I proc a Violet, Tiana removes it. You know what? Let's bank on it. Let's assume that we're gonna proc a Violet. Ah, we didn't proc the Violet. However, Tiana did not do the Winds of Change just now. Alright, Tiana does Winds of Change. Ciara gets to put on another bomb. And we counter with the stun. Alright, then we proc a Violet and we Relentless Strike at half HP. And that's goodbye to Ciara. All through this, look who's still standing strong. He has to take 5 solid nukes to die. They don't have a chance. If they have a chance to do 5 solid nukes on Groggo and you can't kill them, then really, that's your problem, right? Groggo's done his job. He survived 5 nukes. Again, I would like to emphasize that Groggo, although situational, is really effective, especially against the current Ciara meta. Time for random review of the day. It is still Tiana week. Let's go. No lightning. What we got? Bernard, need I say more? Swift. Ideally, Swift will speed HP accuracy or speed HP HP with accuracy substats. Ideally. Reality, speed everywhere you can get. Swift main set, broken offset, as long as you get as much speed as possible. Reality, alright? And we live in the reality. Alright, that's all the time we have for today. Thanks guys for watching, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye!